Just 3 hours from Manhattan, on the eastern tip of Long Island is Montauk, New York. There you'll find a mysterious abandoned military base called Camp Hero that spawned dozens of urban legends, from widespread child abductions to time travel to covert mind control experiments. These bizarre purported occurrences are collectively known as the Montauk Project. Montauk's been an obsession of mine for over 30 years.
The story goes, between 1971 and 1983, secret experiments happened at the Camp Hero Air Force Base, which is only about a mile from here. When I was a kid, I walked along this stretch of shore here, and I didn't realize there was a base here until military personnel stopped me and told me to go the other way. And it sparked my interest for so many years going forward. I spent about 13 years investigating the alleged Montauk Project.
Local children were abducted off the streets, brought to the base, and subjected to brutal mind control experiments right under the now decaying Sage radar tower. To be clear, the government's official position is there is no underground structure of any kind here at Camp Hero.
You know, it's been a long time. I mean, I've been coming back and forth here for, you know, 13 years. But we keep getting prevented to look around the perimeter of the tower.
By whom?
We're trying to get permits to go and look past the gate. We don't get it.
You know, even though I was born and raised here, lived here all my life, that gives me pause to say, well, maybe there was something here. And if you really think there's something here, I think you should pursue it.
Word is spread around town that we're here investigating. And a park employee, Joe Lafreno, has reached out to me, claiming to be one of these victims who are known as the Montauk Boys. He wants to share his version of what happened under Camp Hero, and he's actually agreed to be on camera.
So Joe's boss is here, and he's saying we can't interview.
Well, I don't understand.
Who is he on the phone with? So he's saying you can't interview this gentleman. He knows the gentleman's here.
Well, Joe's hiding in our van.
Oh, okay.
So I don't think his boss knows he's here. Just back up, he'll hop in your car, then drive to the other side of the lot where his boss can't see.
You got it. You got it. Gonna do it.
Okay. Hey, man.
Hey, how you doing?
How's it going?
Doing good. I'm Joe.
Good to meet you, Joe. I'm Chris.
Chris. So, that guy is so strange.
You know? Agreed. Why can't you talk to us? Yeah.
Yeah. I don't even know why he'd go through all that trouble.
I guess that was your supervisor.
Yeah.
He's still sitting there, son of a.
It just leads me to believe that there's something to hide.
It doesn't make any sense to me, and yeah. I work here.
It's good that I'm talking to you because it was difficult to find former Montauk boys that would talk. Did you recall any memories at all of being in any government project?
Yeah. I remember in a big, giant room, we were all young, very young, and it was dark, and I remember Preston Nichols standing in front of us, and he was given orders. Preston was in charge of something. I don't remember him saying specific things, because I can't even say what he was talking about, but I know what he was asking us was, it was criminal stuff.
Really?
Yeah, it was bad. Yeah, so I don't know what was going on. As a matter of fact, I've never remembered any of this before 1994.
That was shortly after Preston's book came out, the first one. That was
right, exactly.
After.
There was like a book signed in Montauk, so I talked to Preston, and I thought it was for the very first time.
Right.
But he said, "Do you remember anything about the underground, or do you remember me?" And I said that I remember you, but it wasn't you. It had to be him like many, many, many years ago.
Wow. So do you think it was a repressed memory?
Yeah. And then Preston said, I have like this ability or whatever to he called it deprogramming, but I believe
right.
It was some type of hypnosis. What I remember was being under hypnosis for about 20 minutes, But yet the clock on the wall said I was under for about 2 hours and 20 minutes.
Wow.
But then he played back a tape, and my voice was on that tape. I said the words, but I don't remember saying the words.
Right.
So it brought back the memories and made them real. Some people have said he probably put a message into your mind when you were under, and so you believe that this is true. But this stuff is just as real as me and you having a conversation.
Wow.
Yeah, that was...
Looks like your boss might be onto us.
What's with this guy? I came to a realization that's, it really just hit me. What I think happened down there, partially. And it would explain a lot of the more fantastic stuff.
I just don't want to have any confrontation with him. You know,
agreed.
You know,
hopefully we get to talk again, man.
Yeah.
I've been reading stories and listening to people who claim they were part of this experiment for many years. Now, Preston Nichols talked about the exact... Sorry.
We're just getting shut down.
Oh, we are?
I think, well, I don't know.
Dude, his boss is blocking his car.
Wow, this guy's a belligerent.
You think he's gonna get fired?
No.
He's saying we can't interview the guy?
Does
this seem weird to you?
Very weird.
But like a little too weird?
Yeah.
Was this yet another attempt by the authorities to obscure the truth? And if so, what are they really hiding?
Can you believe that?
Yeah, what happened?
So he told me I wasn't allowed to talk to anybody.
And what do you think of that?
Well, I said to him, as far as I know, my First Amendment right to speech has not been silenced just because I work for the government.
Right.
We don't work at some top secret government facility, or do we?
No, I hear you,
or
man.
Do we? I mean, all I do is parks maintenance out there. I've been working for the state for 16 and a half years.
Right.
I've never been talked to like that from any boss. I thought he was going to jump right through the window of my
really?
Car.
Really? He was being that aggressive?
Yeah, he was very aggressive.
I've can never, he, can in he my get you life, fired for talking to us?
I can't be fired for speaking. I mean, what have I done wrong? Where have I broken any laws by speaking?
I don't know.